있어. 브레이. Yeah. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. I had to tighten the plan. Yeah. I got it right in the end. Ay. Now we on top, top once again. I don't want it if it ain't love. If it ain't get it away from me. Who you gon' jack if it ain't us? LABB to the bakery. Some mad that I came up. I know my granny gon' pray for me. It was just us in the vacancy. We had to get it from A to B. Wheels never felt like this. Two seats in the hills, how I feel righteous. Blue sheets for the mills, but the deal priceless. New keys can't care what's built private. I might just...
Today, from Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, Jake Elliott takes off for Philadelphia. NFL 21.
Here's the kicker, Jake Elliott, ready to get this one started. And off we go from Lincoln Financial Field.
And this will go as a touchback, and they will begin things at the 25.
Rodgers now on first down. This one complete to Devin Funchess. He'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31. They'll come up now second and four from the 31. Now the man from UTEP, this is Aaron Jones. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Third play here this opening drive as they're up against a third and five. Able to find Lazard. But he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. Rodgers teaming up with Lazard there for a Packer first down. Shotgun now for Rodgers. Slant to Adams. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of nine on first down.
Second and one.
That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and one. The second down attempt there knocked down as it leaves the quarterback's hand and it's incomplete.
Intended for Devontae.
Heavy set out there on third and one.
It's third down.
They'll try and run for it with Jones. And he's got a first down as he's up to the 48.
Aaron Jones.
It's a gain of four there, and it gives him a new set of downs. Two first downs have him up near midfield now on first and 10. And they'll keep on the ground with Jones. He's got a first down and then some inside the 40. And finally marked down at the 23. A big run there, 29 yards and a first. You were telling me this yesterday. This is exactly what they want to do on the opening drive, establish the ground game.
Yeah, remember our conversation we were talking about with one of the GMs in the league. It's told me repeatedly, it's a big man's game. And it's not necessarily size. He's talking about playing some big boy football. Line up, get leverage, knock people back, and establish the run early.
Adams hauling it in from Rodgers.
Rodgers pass.
The reception good for seven. It's third down. Play number nine now on this pretty long opening drive. This is third down. They're going for Lazard, but this is intercepted. Picked off inside the 10. Shreds the tackle. And he will take this all the way up past the 40-yard line.
Rodgers pass. Intercepted.
Out come the Eagles for their first drive, led out by their quarterback in his fifth year in Philly, Carson Wentz.
And when I think of Carson Wentz in his first 4 years in the league, I kind of look at him as bookends because his first year as a rookie, he started all 16 games. The next 2 years, beset by injuries. But
DeSean Jackson off to the races. Touchdown, Philadelphia. John Jackson, 58 yards, and the Eagles have taken the early lead.
Well, that's how you take advantage of an early turnover. A sudden change situation, meaning ball's turned over. How's both sides going to handle it? One side handled it way better. It went right out on the field and put the ball in the end zone.
One play, that just added insult to injury.
Yeah, that just tells you about the defensive side. They didn't come down ready to go. Still reeling from the fact that the ball got turned over.
Taken about 7 yards deep. And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line. The Packers offense here coming back out for their second drive. And there are parts of the last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the inning, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
Well, the second down throw on target. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Out of the shotgun, it's Jones. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. They picked up 5 yards last time. Now they double it and get 10 here.
It's a gain of 10. First down, Packers.
On first and 10, here's Rodgers. That's complete to Lazard. Now a loose football. The ball comes out. And it's picked up by the Eagles. And they will set up shop at their own 41-yard line. And they'll come out with a three tight end look on the first play of the drive. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. 15 yards is the pick up there, and the drive starting very nicely. First down. They show run with three tight ends here on first down. Now he's going to throw deep back over the middle. And incomplete. An excellent play downfield. Should have been picked off, really. But second down instead.
It leads to second and 10.
Play fake to Sanders. Now here's Wentz. Steps away to his left. And that is caught. Well, how about that one? He reeled it in one-handed for a touchdown. So a one-handed grab in the end zone. Nothing much more rewarding than that for a guy catching it.
Not at all. And with what we just saw there, that type of a one-handed catch, what's next? Maybe they go up and almost Velcro it with their jersey in the ball. That's about all that's left. That play, simply spectacular.
So a one-handed grab in the end zone, not much more impressive than that. Now Wentz going to lead the Eagles up to go for two.
Conversion.
Working from the gun, Wentz. And this will be caught. So the try for two, good. And it pushes him out to a 15-0 lead. He hits the big target for the two-point try. Defenses hate those guys, especially around the goal line.
It's hard to decide who you're going to put on him. Are you going to put a smaller corner on him? Are you going to put a safety who doesn't have maybe the same coverage skills? How about a linebacker? He may have the size, but he's not used to really covering in space. That's why the tight end gives you such a great advantage when you're throwing the football.
Their own 25-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And job one here, Charles, just keep possession of the football. Two drives, two turnovers to this point.
You're exactly right, Doctor. Hippocratic oath. First, do no harm. And right now, they're harming themselves on offense.
I like that. No one is mistaking me for a doctor, though. But thank you, Dr. Davis. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. That's complete to the former Aggie, Jay Sternberger. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. 5 yards. Now it's 3rd and 5. The last play on the completion got him half of what they needed. Now here's a tough 3rd and 5. He's got the hook up to Lazard. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
Now a first down carry by Jones. Jones hit and the ball's out.
The ball carried by the wide receiver.
Wow, that ball gets knocked free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. Almost like, it's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home, the next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover.
That's what you're going to need to do against those big receivers. You got to get in there and get physical with them. That time he got in close, got in tight, and knocked the ball away.
They tried the throw on second down, unsuccessful. Now it's third and one. Rodgers going to throw. And he gets it to Funchess, complete. And he gets it down to the 48, enough for the first. A second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. On first down, Jones. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Brings up second and 12 at the Eagles' 49-yard line.
On second and 12, Rodgers setting up the screen here. Aaron Jones. And he'll lose yardage here back at the 47. They'll wind up losing 4 yards on the play. And they're going to be staring at a third and long here. Third and 15 here after the first and second down plays went in the wrong direction. He's got Adams on the hookup. Roger. And he has another first down as they'll get the ball down to the Eagles 30. Boy, a nice play there as they wind up converting on third and 15. 15-0 our score. It's the NFL on EA Sports.
15. Packers nothing.
Flush. Now look out. Rodgers lost the football. And it's picked up by the Eagles. And he will return this one to the 30-yard line.
Whenever I see a team turn it over on back-to-back drives, fumbles on their last two, I know one person's blood pressure who is starting to rise, and that's the head coach.
Absolutely. And when's it going to go down? When they stop fumbling?
When they stop fumbling and after he's assessed the game film, and only if they manage to win the game.
No gain on the play.
If this defense wants to stay in this ballgame, they've got to start ending some drives. That helps.
And they have to look ahead at what they expect the offense to do, and right now with that lead, that's run the football. So you don't just stack the line of scrimmage. You have to get upfield and try and make some plays in their backfield.
Left side here to Sanders. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. It's an Eagles first down on a gain of 11. To throw, Wentz.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
26 more yards.
A good pickup there, 26 yards. So into Packer territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 26-yard line. To throw, it's Wentz. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Dean Lowry, credit him with a sack as he buries him for a loss of 10. He'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. They get 7 there on the screen. It'll set up a third down.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
Play action. Now Wentz. And he connects with Ertz. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers' 13-yard line. A big play there as they get the conversion on third and 13.
Really? Really? Did we just see that? That's a big catch. One-handed, I might add, to pick up a first down.
I was going
to
say, on third down for the defense, it's one thing to give up a reception. You just got to shake your head on a one-handed catch to pick up the first. From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. They go back to the ground with Sanders. And he'll work free from one tackle, but that's about all as he's taken down. 5 yards on the carry, good pickup on first down.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a game considering the blitz that they just had against them.
And just shy of the goal line as he's out of bounds right at the one. It's an 8-yard pickup, and it leads to a first and goal.
Certainly making his presence felt in both the pass and the run game. He's having an impact.
Yeah, his first carry of the game right there. He had hurt him with his arm. Now he's showing that he can shuffle the puppies as well.
They'll come out in the pistol. They scored touchdowns on drives one and two, and now they're trying to make it a perfect 3-for-3 to start.
Delayed game, offense.
Hey, we gonna do what we do.
He didn't even try to signal for a timeout, so they must have not been aware of the numbers.
I think he lost track of the time left in the play clock and probably was trying to read the defense and trying to figure out which play to run and just lost track, and it cost him.
Rolling to his right. And that will be caught, but out of bounds. Out of bounds, ruled incomplete here. And that one goes incomplete. They tried something out of the bag of tricks, but it's incomplete, and now second down. Wentz on the give to Sanders. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. A 6-yard touchdown run. And the Eagles add on to their lead. And now they'll empty the backfield here as they elect to go for two. So simple math here in the first half. They've had three drives offensively, and they have scored every time, and they've got the lead.
Well, whenever we talk about adjustments, we usually talk about an offense making adjustments, right? This is all about the defense. They've got to figure out some way, somehow, to slow them down. Do they blitz a little bit more? Do they play more zone coverage? Right now, they don't know where to go because they're hitting them in every direction.
And it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return. The Green Bay offense ready to take over. And some dangerous territory. You're already down three scores. A three and out here or an inability to put any points up. This one might be over by half.
Yeah, and what you also have to guard against is calling every play for a big shot downfield. You know, thinking you're going to get all these points back on one drive. You're not, and last time I looked, it's still the first half. I'm not saying you have ultimate patience here, but you also don't have to go ahead and force everything either.
So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield. Shotgun now for Rodgers. He'll get this to Lazard. Now the ball comes loose, and it's picked up by the Eagles. And to the 40-yard line, that's where the return stops. And now three drives, three fumbles.
What's amazing about it is when we go around and watch practices, how many times do we see them put that sleeve over a football now to make it more slippery and hard?
And this will be caught at the 30. And he works free. And oh, so close as he takes it all the way to the 2-yard line. A big play there for Philly. 57 yards. They've got three tight ends here on first and goal to add some extra mass. From the gun, it's Wentz. And he is going to go down. Back at the 11-yard line. The safety, Adrian Amos, comes crashing in for the sack.
Well, if you're going to throw the ball on first and goal from the two, the worst thing that should result is an incompletion for you offensively. But, Brandon, this is a different type of football. Back in my day, first and goal from the two, a lot of big people with big neck rolls, they were on the field trying to ram it into the end zone.
And he's unable to haul it in, so it falls incomplete over the middle third of the field, and that brings up fourth. Going for it with Sanders. And he's not going to get in. They stop him at the one. They'll get neither the touchdown nor the first down. And it'll be a turnover on downs. And defensively, they were ready for that. A full-on blitz on fourth down, and they stop him short of the marker.
Oh, someone's got to feel really good about that, and that's the defensive coordinator. He dialed up a great run blitz defense, and they hit it just right. Stack that thing up. They're going to feel awesome going to the bench after that big play.
Hey, over, over, over.
Now Rodgers throwing on second down. And this is caught. Mercedes Lewis with a grab. And they work this out past the 25. The extra effort after the catch makes it good for a gain of 26 and also a first down. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. A first down run by Jones not going to work out as he's hit and dropped behind the line of scrimmage.
The tackle made by Derek Barnett. Taken down back at the 23-yard line.
Now on second and 13. Rodgers looking middle, and that's complete.
Complete to Alan Lazard.
They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to him? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
We remind you that coming up at halftime, Jonathan Coachman will be alongside. He'll have highlights and analysis from Orlando of this first half of action. And Adams has it, complete.
Rodgers.
And he will have a first down here at about the 40. Rodgers finding Adams for a Packer first.
And there was absolutely zero pressure on the quarterback on that play. Third down, and he has all the time in the world to eventually find an open receiver for a first down pickup.
So second down and 10. Once again, they'll go for the 40. Throwing again. Rodgers. He'll get this one into the hands of Lewis. Oh, and Lewis lost the football. And it's picked up by the Eagles. And his guys will set up shop at midfield at the 50-yard line.
By the Eagles.
Always costly to cough up that football. These defenders, they become so adept, though, at jarring it free.
Yeah, it's amazing that there aren't more fumbles caused, because now, if you're an offensive player, you go through ball security drills every single day. It's really not out of line to think you should take the ball to bed with you and just hold on to it. But the bottom line is, no matter how much you try to protect it, these guys are pretty good at finding ways to knock it out.
A gain of 13, it's a first down. Shotgun now for Wentz. He's going to take a shot for the end zone and nearly picked it off. He had a chance to come down with that in the end zone, but it'll wind up just being incomplete.
Second and 10.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Wentz to throw again. And his throw is incomplete. Jair Alexander that time able to knock that one away. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. Eluding the pressure right. He's going to go up top for the end zone. And that will be incomplete.
When you look at the scoreboard, you'd think they'd be pretty comfortable right now with this lead, but these guys are absolutely not going to let up. They want to increase their lead, and they want to do it with a big play. Unable to connect in that attempt.
And this is caught at the 8. Some collective exhales over there on the sideline. A big pickup through the air on fourth down to bring up first and goal. And this is caught in the end zone by Jalen Reagor. Touchdown, Eagles. Three touchdown passes now for Carson Wentz. And this offense continues to pour it on.
That's one of the better examples of clock management I've seen. Whittled it all the way down just about and still put the ball in the end zone.
And just a methodical drive and something really to take into the lockers here. And he is into the end zone. So they get two more on the board here just before halftime.
31.
And they're able to ground it in there on the two-point try. And you and I were talking before the game, the two-point conversions from the 15-16 season, what has changed, what hasn't changed, partner?
Yeah, I'll tell you what's changed is just your normal strategy, because now you're either kicking the football with the ball on the 15-yard line, or if you decide to go for two, they put it on the 2-yard line. So what are you thinking as a coach? Do I risk it? Do I go for it here? Do I try and gain a strategic advantage and maybe go for two early? That's what people are wondering about.
He'll have a first down past the 40. And an anxious moment or two there, but they do get him down. And we're going to get a timeout. With 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Looking deep for Adams. And the throw left sideline here is caught, but they'll rule it incomplete. Couldn't keep his feet in. And okay, so much for our halftime break. Apparently we're going to get right back to it.
Packers, nothing.
So the halftime break behind us, and we are back underway with the third quarter of action. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
Yeah, what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. Just his second catch of the game so far. This one moves the chains. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down. Rolling to his left. He'll try and run it. And some strong running. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Opted to run for it. The decision a good one. Picking up the first, getting 14 yards on the scramble.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your...
And he'll score! Touchdown, Eagles! Taking it in from 11 yards out. And the Eagles are pouring it on. And now they'll empty the backfield here as they elect to go for two. Not the first time on the drive we saw him take matters into his own hands, and this time he finishes things off with a touchdown run.
You're not going to be happy with me, but I think he took matters into his own feet, didn't he?
Oh, Davis from the top rope. I like it. That's fielded on the back line of the end zone.
Take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. Now a throw left sideline here is complete. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down. From the gun on third down, Rodgers.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone and nearly picked it off. He had a chance to come down with that in the end zone, but it'll wind up just being incomplete. It's a second down run with Sanders. 5 yards. Now it's third and five. Sanders, and they're going to hurry back to the line now.
He's tackled at the 27-yard line.
From the gun on third down, Wentz. And he can't quite pick it. No interceptions so far. That probably should have been their first, but at least it's fourth down.
4 yard attempt.
They certainly had good starting field position on that drive, but couldn't do anything with it after three plays. Have to admit that that's a disappointing end to excellent field position. When that drive started, they had 6 points that they were thinking about.
They got the interception, but very little movement after, and that forces him to settle for three. And it does feel like settling when that happens, doesn't it?
It certainly does, but we got to give a lot of credit where it's due, and that's to the defense, because they ran onto the field. It's what we call sudden change, right? Interception, you got to go put out the fire, and they did, holding them to a field goal.
Rodgers will break the huddle and bring the pack up first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Here's a throw, complete right side to start things out. And he lost the football, and it's picked up by the Eagles.
We have seen this before, and we know coaches preach about this and work on it all the time. Catch the ball. You know there's going to be some traffic somewhere. They've got to put it away and secure it as they try and get downfield.
And a lot of talent on this Eagle defense, and you've seen it on these last two plays, both losses.
And it's third down.
Here's Rodgers from the gun on third down. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. 63 yards receiving for him now. And that last catch, good enough for a first down. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Now this one over the middle into the hands of his tight end complete. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and 2. Facing a second and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. The first carry now for the BYU man. It's Jamal Williams.
Number 30.
Oftentimes we praise an offense for their variety of being able to hit people with the run and the pass. But in this game, how about what we're seeing from the safeties? They are all over the field. Doesn't matter if they threw it or if they're trying to run it.
I don't think we've ever awarded an MVU most valuable unit, but you're right. It might go to them in this game.
I like that. MVU. Well done. Alan Lazard.
11 yards and a Green Bay Packer first down. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. Rodgers' throw going to be caught by Funchess. And a loose football. But this will get out of bounds, so possession will stay the same.
Fumble on the play. Out of bounds, the offense retains possession.
On first and 10, here's Rodgers. And a nice job to break free of one tackle, but it slowed his momentum somewhat, and he's taken down right after. 3 yards the gain there, second down. That first down completion only netted him 3. Second and 7. Now left side, a completion to his tight end. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down. Rodgers now on first down. Over the middle, that's caught by Adams. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. A good-looking drive for the Packers so far. It's a first down. Rodgers again now. His pass caught at the 4. Oh, and Lewis lost the football. And it's picked up by the Eagles. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Obviously, you got to hold on to the football, but I've got to give credit to the defense there. Good job of knocking it free.
Yeah, because a lot of the time we just blame the offensive players for not taking care of it. How about the effort of the defensive players knowing that guys are going to, and if they're good, anticipate the contact coming and try and cover up the football, and they still find ways to knock it free.
9-yard line.
Throwing again on second down. Wentz.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Face mask. Defense.
Tack on 15 more for the face mask, and that becomes a huge play.
Big pass gets caught on you. You're doing everything possible to get him on the ground.
And they're going to get him. He's taken down for a sack. Back at the 47-yard line. Well, Za'Darius Smith there getting in and bringing him to the ground.
Got to give him points for the attempt. But there's just a wave of pressure there. A host of people in the area. Evades a few, but couldn't evade all of them.
Give him 6 on the run. They're going to be faced now with a 3rd and 12. He's going to let this go deep. That's caught inside the 20. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. On 1st and 10, it's Sanders.
We talk about mobility on quarterback all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and his accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
Flushed out right. That is caught at the 7. He's going to be out of bounds on what's going to wind up being the final play of quarter number 3. And welcome back. We are in the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia. They'll try to run with Sanders. And this is a blowout so far as we get set for the 4th quarter. A very one-sided affair. Once again with Sanders. And he's in for an Eagles touchdown. Miles Sanders, his 2nd touchdown of the afternoon as his guys continue to pour it on. So another score there. Often you talk about the three phases of the game. Defense, offense, special teams. It's been a clean sweep in this one, hasn't it?
It certainly has. They've been pretty dominant throughout this game. And privately, the head coach will add a fourth phase. That's the coaching. And he'll tell the ownership that as he tries to negotiate a new contract off of this win.
Well, they are looking strong here in the fourth quarter. More difficult attempt here from the 20. And now again, the play clock's going to run out on him. That's going to set him back 5 yards. Well, now things get a little dicier here. It's a 42-yard extra point attempt. And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. So that drive takes them down the field in 8 plays. And it was Miles Sanders who finished it off with a touchdown run. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. Fielded in the end zone. And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25.
And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. And let's face it, this drive is not going to have any bearing on this game, but it's kind of important for one reason, isn't it?
It certainly is. You got to get points. And okay, all right, I'm being facetious here. But you get points, you feel a little bit better about yourself as you move on to the next one.
An incomplete pass leads to 2nd and 10 from the 25. Now a toss left side into the hands of his tight end. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be 3rd and less than a yard. The offense on 3rd down tonight, they've been tough to stop. 8 for 10 so far. They're looking at 3rd in the nose of the football. And that's complete to Lewis. Yeah, he's got this to the 30 before being taken down.
Complete.
Give him 35 yards there on the 3rd down conversion. So the big play has him all the way down to the 30 now for 1st and 10. Rodgers to throw once more. Slant to Adams. And finally, down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. Last play went for over 30 yards. This one not quite as big, but still over 20. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's 1st and goal.
57's the mic. Watch 57.
Again, they'll throw with Rodgers. And he's caught. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. That'll bring out 2nd and goal after the gain of 5. More muscle up front for this 2nd and 2. They've got 3 tight ends out there. And they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. Call it a gain of 2 as they're knocking on the door now. 3rd and goal. A big play forthcoming. Here's 3rd and goal. Diving for the end zone, and the ball's knocked out. And it's picked up by the Eagles. He's got daylight. He's at the 50, the 30, the 20, 10. And he is not quite going to make it all the way in. They'll mark him down right about the 1-yard line.
As they say, this game hasn't exactly been one for the books. I mean, we're into the 4th quarter here, and now this happens.
And he's in. Touchdown, Eagles. Taking it in from 1 yard out. And the Eagles take advantage of good field position.